This morning I went to search for a mountain. It is called Mount Fudeste, which means as much as Mount, I am throwing away my brush, because a revered Japanese artist in the past tried to paint it, but felt he failed to capture its beauty. Hiroshige felt no such restraint. Instead, he decided to feature it in his image for the Tokaido's 48th station. Apparently, the mountain remained pretty popular in his time, because there is a tea house near an overlook, where various people sit and relax to admire the famous view. Not far away, the old Tokaido continues its course. It is not very busy along this stretch of the old road, so I'm glad to get a ride with a group of hikers. Today they are heading towards Suzuka Pass, the last major mountain pass on the old Tokaido prior to Kyoto. The ride takes us through the former post town and then meanders up into the mountains. A bit further, noisy Route 1 joins in, and for a short distance, old and new Tokaido run side by side. One of my companions tells me a bit more about the area.
昔はいわゆる東海道、いわゆるあの関所があってね、あの交通の要だったんですね。今でもあの道路のですね、この要になってるからですね、非常にあのどこへ行くにもですね、非常に便利なとこですし、今のその旧広重の歩いたね、旧東海道が残されてちゃんと守られてるしね、そういう点では非常に住みやすいんじゃない。
It may be well maintained, but the vicinity of Route 1 doesn't necessarily make it pleasant. Fortunately, nearer the pass, the old Tokaido peels off and turns into a footpath. From here, all the way to the top of the pass and beyond, we are by ourselves. On the way down, the scenery reminds me of the image Hiroshige made for Tsuchiyama. It shows some houses set amidst the trees. As earlier in Shono, it is pouring. The head of a daimyo's entourage, clad in raincoats, is crossing a small bridge and about to enter the town. Today, Route 1 makes the approach look and sound less peaceful. But just a bit further, the old Tokaido peels off once more, leading into what was once the 49th station. Somewhere near the center of town, I take a break at a kisaten. The unofficial headquarters of the Tokaido Network Association, this is an obligatory stop for today's Tokaido traveler. Owner Hideru Ukai has been promoting the old Tokaido for the past 20 years. He has seen a lot of walkers pass through here. I ask him what makes people set out to do so.
どうなんだろう、古いものを訪ねるということで、その日本の良さを掘り起こしている人もあるし、ただ歩いてるだけの人もありますね。あの、まあ健康のために始めたという人が多いんですけど、あの自分の近所の東海道を歩いてて、それ飽き足らずにだんだん伸ばしてって、ここまで来てしまったと関東の方はよく言われますね。
I suspect Hiroshige should assume some of the blame as well, because I'm certainly not the only one who is interested in finding the exact location of his images.
必ずどこにあった、どこの風景かなというようなことは尋ねて見えるみたいですね。
But there is more to it than that. The novelty of comparing past and present wears off after a while, in no small part because so much of that past has disappeared.Besides, it's not always a very pretty walk. Traveling the old Tokaido often means walking through suburbia or breathing diesel fumes on its newer counterpart. Tokaido devotees realize something needs to be done about that.
Tokaido にどうしたら人がもっと集まってくるかなというような話をしてるんですけどね。あの、それとまあ楽しく歩いていただけるように整備しないかんというような話をいつもこうやってるんですけどね。
A bit beyond Ukai's Kisaten is a place committed to preserving not only the road, but also the memories of those who walked it in the past. It is the Tenmakan Museum. Mari Fukui is its curator.
土山宿は江戸から宿場としては49番目でした。で、鈴鹿峠を東の方から来て鈴鹿峠を越した一番最初にある宿場町でした。道も細いし、歩く人にとってはすごく大変な旅やったです。それからあと山賊追いはぎみたいなのが出て、で、荷物を取られたりお金を取られたりっていうこともありましたので、すごい怖くて、苦労してみんな渡ってきたと思います。
I suppose then that those travelers would have been glad to get here. But this place would have been a lot busier than it is now.
旧東海道沿いにこの建物のちょうど横のところに問屋場っていうのがありまして、でその問屋場っていうのは宿場から宿場まで人とか荷物とかを運ぶ乗り継ぐ場所だったんですね。だから宿場の中枢機関でした。でそこの中の乗り継いでいく馬のことが天馬って言うんですね。100頭ぐらいいました。江戸時代には100頭。
Tsuchiyama's cargo carrying horses are long gone. They have been replaced by the thousands of small trucks and vans that crisscross the country every day, making deliveries and picking up boxes and packages and just about anything else the Japanese don't want to carry themselves when traveling. Toshitaka Watanabe has a few deliveries scheduled and invites me along for the ride.Since he is heading in the direction of Minakuchi, I happily accept. The old Tokaido usually makes for an interesting ride, but all too soon, we're back on the main road. Still,The landscape on either side is quite nice. We have now entered the Kansai Plain, and it only takes a short diversion to find rolling tea plantations on one side, or superb rural scenes, reminiscent of Hiroshige's image for Minakuchi, the Tokaido's 50th station.The center of Minakuchi is a bit busier today, though that is not necessarily an improvement. But it certainly makes getting a ride somewhat easier. My companion this time is Hiroyuki Yamamoto, who spends most of his time shuttling cement. He is kind enough to take me as far as Ishibe, the old road's 51st station.I get off in front of Sakura's, one of the many pachinko parlors located along Route 1. There are nearly 15,000 of these all over Japan, servicing an estimated 16 million regular users. They all share the same garish architecture, inside as well as outside, and are filled with deafening noise, bright lights, and cigarette smoke. This is a massive industry.Possibly the largest moneymaker in all of Japan. Matsuo Inoue is manager of this particular parlor.
パチンコはですね、玉を弾いて特定のところに入ったら、数字が回って、数字が、揃えば大当たりと言いまして、玉がどんどん出てくるシステムになっております。その お金を借りて玉を借りていただいて、その玉を増やして楽しむ、交換して景品を持ち帰るという、いわばギャンブルのようなものです。
The workings don't need too much explanation. But why would anyone want to come play or gamble here? So I ask Inoue about that as well.
ギャンブルですので、やはり入った時点で 精神が高揚してアドレナリンが出てっていうような、もう第二こういうふうな状況になりますのでね、あまり気にされない方が多いのは実情です。やっぱり年配層のお客様がそういったものを特に好まれまして。
I see plenty of younger people as well, a good many of which appear to be collecting bucketfuls of little balls. They are the so-called pachinko pros who play the machines all day long for a living. They make money doing it, but for most, pachinko is a losing proposition, which often leads to sad situations.Why you would want to lose your money doing this beats me. But it is not the first time on this trip that simple questions do not necessarily have a simple answer. Which is exactly what keeps the trip so interesting.